In this lecture of the transformer, we will derive the equation of the transformer. A transformer has two sides of section, primary side and the secondary side. In the primary side, we have primary winding or primary coil, which have an N1 number of turns, and in the secondary side, we have secondary winding or secondary coil, where the number of turns is equal to N2. Flux generated in the primary winding gets linked with the secondary winding, and the flux which are not linked to the secondary winding are called leakage flux. On the primary winding is connected to a source of sinusoidal alternating voltage, or input voltage to the primary winding is V1, which is sinusoidal in nature, then the sinusoidal alternating flux is generated in the magnetic core which links both primary and secondary winding. Then, due to the flux linking, self-induced voltage in the primary is equal to U1 and the current in the primary winding is equal to I1. And the mutually induced voltage in the secondary winding is equal to E2, which is connected across the load, and the current in the secondary is equal to I2, and the voltage across the load is equal to V2. As the flux generated is sinusoidal in nature, it can be represented by a sinusoidal waveform. This flux oscillates between maximum amplitude of plus phi m and minimum amplitude of minus phi m, with the time period t and the frequency f, which is equal to 1 by t. Let's say the maximum value of the flux in waiver is equal to plus phi m, and the minimum value of the flux in waiver is equal to minus phi m. And if the supply voltage frequency in hertz is equal to f, and number of turns in the primary is equal to N1, number of turns in the secondary is equal to N2, and self-induced voltage in the primary is equal to E1, and mutually induced voltage in the secondary is equal to E2. The flux changes from maximum plus phi m to minimum minus phi m. The flux is equal to plus phi m. Here the flux is maximum when the time t is equal to t by 4. It is minimum when t is equal to 3t by 4. So the time required for the flux to change from maximum to minimum is equal to 3t by 4 minus t by 4, which is equal to 2t by 4, which can be simplified as t by 2 or 1 by twice f seconds, as t is equal to 1 by f. So this flux changes from plus phi m to minus phi m in half of the time period. So average rate of change of flux is equal to plus phi m minus minus phi m divided by t by 2, which is equal to 2 into phi m divided by 1 by twice f, which is equal to 4f phi m waver. Now, the rate of change of flux per turn is equal to average induced EMF in volts. So we can write average induced EMF is equal to 4f phi m volt. Now, we know that form factor is equal to RMS value divided by average value. So the RMS value is equal to form factor into average value. For a sinusoidal wave, this form factor is equal to 1.11. So the RMS value of the induced EMF per turn is equal to form factor into average value. Now the form factor for the sinusoidal wave of flux is equal to 1.11. So the RMS value of the induced EMF per turn is equal to 1.11 into average value, which is 4f phi m volt, which is equal to 4.44f phi m volt. Since the primary and secondary have N1 and N2 number of turns respectively, the RMS value of the induced EMF in primary E1 is equal to induced EMF per turn into number of turns in the primary winding. So U1 is equal to 4.44F into phi m into N1, which will result in 4.44N1F phi m. Similarly, the RMS value of induced EMF in the secondary, or E2, is equal to induced EMF per turn, which is 4f phi m into N2, or E2 is equal to 4.44 N2f phi m. For an ideal transformer or no load, supply voltage is equal to primary induced voltage, or V1 is equal to U1, and the load voltage or terminal voltage is equal to secondary induced voltage, or V2 is equal to E2. So the primary induced voltage E1 is equal to 4.44 N1f phi m volt, and the secondary induced voltage E2 is equal to 4.44 N2F phi m volt. Voltage transformation ratio. It is the ratio of primary induced voltage to secondary induced voltage, or U1 by E2, which is equal to number of turns in the secondary divided by number of turns in the primary, and it is equal to K. If N2 is greater than N1, then K will be greater than 1, and this transformer will be known as a step-up transformer. If N2 is less than N1, then K will be less than 1, then this transformer will be known as a step-down transformer. And also for the ideal transformer, input volt ampere is equal to output volt ampere, or V1 into I1 is equal to V2 into I2, which can be simplified as I2 by I1 is equal to V1 by V2, which is equal to 1 by K.
This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.